The latest update to Power BI made some of our videos completely redundant because of field parameters. For example, if you want to switch between percentage and absolute values, well, now you can set it up in a much easier way. Or maybe you want to have an easy way to switch between different breakdowns on the axis or the legend. Now, to set that up used to be a big hassle, but now you can set it up like this with field parameters. So let's start exploring. Welcome to How to Power BI. My name is Bas, and if this is the very first time for you visiting this channel, then make sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date on all of my videos in which I share everything I know about Power BI. Now let's talk about a new preview feature that has been added to the May 22 version of Power BI, which is field parameters, which I think can already be considered one of the biggest upgrades to Power BI for the year. Why? Because it's super useful. It lets the end user switch in a very easy way between different fields that you maybe have on the axis or on the legend. Or maybe you want the end user to switch very easily between different measures that you show on a chart. Now, to set this up before was possible. However, it took a lot of effort and you had to use calculation groups or work with bookmarks. And all of that is not necessary anymore. Now it's easy as 1, 2, 3. Now, let me show you how it works. So for this example, I have a simple bar chart where I show the sales on the y-axis. And now I want to create a breakdown. Now, here I could go to the table, let's say dim product, and take over here the product category name, put that on the axis, and there you have your breakdown. But now I want to have the option for the user to switch to a different breakdown. And that's where field parameters come in. Now, to make use of this new preview feature, you have to make sure that you're on the May 22 version or later. And under options, you need to have it turned on under preview options. Now, with that in place, you can go to modeling. And here we can insert a new parameter. And you see now we have two different types. Now, the normal one, numeric range, that was already there. But the new one is fields parameter. So let's click on it. And now we can give our parameter a name. So instead of parameter, we can call this one PRM for parameter and then breakdown list. Okay. Then we can choose from our tables which fields we want to use. Now here I want to go to my product table. Let's say we want to have a breakdown by product category name. And then I want the end user also to be able to switch in a very easy way to, let's say, a breakdown by the different cities. All right, now with these two in place, I can now click here on create, and that's it. We have now our first fields parameter. Now, how does it look like? Let's switch to the data view first. And then you see here on the right-hand side, we have a new table that's not connected to any of the other tables, which is called PRM breakdown list. And so a field parameter basically shows up as a new table in your data model. Now, if we open it, then you see we have three columns inside of this table, two of which are hidden. Now, the first one, PRM breakdown list, there we have the column names, so the measure names. Then in the second one, the field name. And in the third one, there you have the sort order. And in the formula bar, there we see the DAX expression that generates this table. And later we can make some further adjustments here. Now, let's go back to the report view. And here we have a slicer that contains a parameter, PRM breakdown list. Now, if we make a selection, nothing happens. Okay, because we are not using the parameter yet in our visualization. So let's go here to the column chart. And then instead of using product category name, I'm going to use our parameter. So let's drag PRM breakdown list onto the x-axis. And here you see we have now a breakdown by the product category name. And I can switch to the city. And that's it. And this is simply mind-blowing if you compare this to the old way of how to set this up. But what if you now forgot a field? How can we add or delete one of these fields that we show on the parameter? Well, before you would have gone over here to transform data and then added parameters, but these are the other ones, okay? The ones that you set up in Power Query. Now, remember this parameter, the table that it adds, is created with a DAX expression. So that is not going to work. So if we want to edit the field parameter, we have to select the table, then go here to the formula bar, and then here we can make adjustments to the expression. So for example, if we want to add a field, we can simply copy the field that's above it. And then here, instead of city, let's say we want to have the promotion that we ran. And the field that we're going to use, we can get with the name of function. and we want to get it from the promotion table. So I can refer here to the promotion name. Now that last number that you see there at the end, that is the sort number. So let's put that one at the end. So I give it number 2. And of course we need a comma there in between. All right. And now we have promotion in a slicer. So let's click on it and we have a breakdown by the different promotions. So now we know how to set up these field parameters and make adjustments. But let's have a look at another use case. Now let's select the visualization, and instead of having it here on the axis, it can also be super useful to have it on the legend. Now you see, we have now one bar, but different colors for the different promotions. And now we can break it down, let's say over time. So I go here to my date table, date hierarchy, put it on the x-axis, and then expand down, let's say to the month level. Now, over here I select the promotions, but I can also switch to the cities or the product category name. And you see, instead of having this breakdown, this extra detail that we add to the chart on the x-axis, we now use it for the legend. So that is already super useful. However, it lets us do more. It also lets us switch between different measures. Now let's say here we are looking at the absolute sales values, and we want to have an easy way to switch to, let's say, the percentage of total. Now, here I already created these two separate measures. So we have a sales measure and we have a sales percentage of total measure. Now, these measures themselves, that doesn't matter for now. However, I want to find now an easy way to switch back and forth between the absolute values and the percentage of total values. Okay, now this is where field parameters come in again. So I go here to modeling, new parameter fields, and let's rename it. So over here for the parameter, I start with PRM. And here I'm going to have a measure list. So let's call it like that, measure list. Now, which measures do I want to toggle between? So the absolute sales and the sales percentage of total. I also want to have the slicer, and let's click on create. Now the same thing happened as before. We have a new table, PRM measure list, and we have a slicer that uses that first column. And there we can switch between the different measures, sales and sales percentage of total. However, we are not using that parameter yet on the visualization, so that's the next thing that we have to change. So let's select the visual, and then here we have now on the y-axis sales. However, I don't want to have sales, I want to use the parameter. So I'm going to drag the parameter on the y-axis, and you see we have now the percentage of total. And we can now switch to sales and back. All right, now before, you had to do this also with calculation groups or with bookmarks, and that is not necessary anymore. Now to improve this a little bit further, let's take the visual and then go to formatting options and let's add some data labels to it. Now it's not really visible, so let's open this up. And then here under values, there we can make the labels a little bit smaller so that we can see the percentages. Okay, and if I switch here to the sales measure, well, you see, well, the labels don't show in percentage formatting. No, now we show it in millions. So also the formatting is taken care of, which is super useful. Now let's go back to the slicer, slicer settings. Now here you probably want to make a few changes. Now let's say we want to go for horizontal, and then here on the selection, I would select single select. And then here the slicer header we can turn off, and then resize it so that it shows right next to one another. And then we can put it here in the top right corner of the visual, so that now we can easily switch back and forth between the two measures. And maybe also important to know is that all of these field parameters, they can be used in combination, right? I can still switch between the different breakdowns, and I can still switch between the different measures. Now let's look at one more example for which we need to do a little bit more customization. Now here we have the sales broken down by the different product categories. And on the y-axis, I also place the subcategory name and the product name. Now, as a user, I could make use of the expand down feature that you have here at the top. So we can say expand down, or maybe over here, go to the next level in the hierarchy to see the next level. Okay, now that works. However, this doesn't let you control all of the other visualizations on the report page. And it's also maybe not as intuitive as you need it to be for your end users. So instead of that, we're going to make use of field parameters again. All right, so I'm gonna take away what we have here on the y-axis. And after you remove them, we go again to modeling, new parameter, fields. Now this parameter we can call PRM and then product field list. Okay, Now, here we want to have from the product table, now product category, we want to have the subcategory, and we want to have the product name. Now, that is pretty straightforward. Click on create. And then we have a slicer, and for the chart, we need to place on the y-axis the column from product field list. Okay, so the parameter. Now, if we select product category name, we see breakdown by the product categories, subcategory name, product name. Okay, so that is working. Now, same as before, but now I want to customize this a bit further. Maybe you also want to have an option here that we can choose the top 10 products. Well, how to do that? Well, for that, you need to go to the products table. So let's go to the data view. Now, to know if a product is in the top 10 based on sales, we need to, well, rank the product. So I'm going to add over here a new column, and let's call this one top 10 products. And then over here, we need to use a rank X function because we want to take the sales amount for each product and see how it compares to all of the other products and rank them. Okay, and rank X lets us do that. Now the table that we want to iterate is the product table. Okay, so over here, we can just refer to DIM product. Now, then for each product, we want to get the sales. Now over here, I already have a sales measure, sales. All right, and now it will, well, give me the rank based on sales for each product. Now let's see if this is true. Press enter and you see we have a new column with the ranking of each product. Okay, so that works. However, I don't want to have the ranking. I want to check if it's in the top 10. So I need an if function. And then we can say, okay, if, now this number that rank X comes up with, if it's equal to or lower than 10, then I would like to return the product name. All right, so over here we can just refer to the product name. All right. And otherwise, well, we just leave it blank. So now that we have that new column, well, we need to go to the parameter. So here we don't see that new option, top 10, in a parameter yet. So here we can select the parameter and then update the expression. So here, let's take that last row that we have there and then Alt Shift down to duplicate it to the next line. And let's also put in that comma before we forget it. And then here, I'm going to call this one top 10 products name of. Now, here we don't want to have the product name, but we want to have that top 10 products column that we just added. And here, let's also, and here at the end, let's make it to a 3, which is the sort order. And it kind of works. We do have the top 10. However, there's also a big bar for the total sum of sales for all of the other products, which you, of course, don't want to show. Now, how can we get rid of it? Now, one thought that you might have is to take the visual, then go to the filter section, and then here, top 10 products. Well, here we don't want to have the blanks. However, the problem is that if you filter out the blanks, the filter still applies also if you select one of the other fields. So that is not gonna work. So what other alternative do we have? Well, we can write a measure that we then use as a filter. I'm gonna add a new measure and let's call this one products filter. Now here, the filter we only wanna apply when the item top 10 products is selected. So I'm gonna start with a function and how can we check which item is selected? Well, we can do select the value or max. Now let's go for max. And here we are gonna look at the PRM product field list. Now we need this one. All right, so we want to check if it is equal to, and here, this is the name of the item, top 10 products. Okay, so this is the first condition that we need to check for, and we also want to see if the top 10, so also here, max, and then top 10 products, if it's equal to blank, okay, because only those, and we want to filter out. And now, if both of these conditions hold, then we can return, let's say, 0, and otherwise we can return a 1. All right, now over here, the quotation marks you don't need, so here we can just type a 0, all right, and close the if function. So we have the measure, select the visual, then open here the filter panel, and on the filter panel, there we can now take the product filter measure, drag it on filters on this visual, and then here we can say that it needs to be equal to 1. Then press apply filter. I see our visual doesn't include the blanks anymore. So now we have the top 10 products. And this way we can customize the fields that we show on a parameter in any way we like. So you see how amazing and valuable this new feature is. Now, if you have some other interesting applications, just let me know in the comment section below. Also, if you have any questions, if you still want to explore the old way of doing it, then check out these videos over here. I want to thank you for watching, and I see you in the next video.